Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be going over the life cycle of moss as an example of a bryophyte life cycle. Mosses are a group of small plants that all lack vascularization and produce spores instead of seeds. Mosses undergo an alternation of generations in their life cycle, which consists of two generations, the gametophyte generation, which is haploid, and the sporophyte generation, which is diploid. The gametophyte generation starts with haploid spores being released from capsules on the ends of the moss sporophytes. These spores grow through the process of mitosis, first forming a thread-like chain of cells known as the protonemata, which is still haploid. From here, haploid buds form along the growing chain of cells, which will eventually grow into the leafy shoots. It continues to grow into what is known as the gametophyte, which is still haploid. The mature gametophyte has a stem-like structure with leaf-like structures coming off of it, as well as rhizoids that work as a root-like system. The gametophyte generation is the dominant generation in mosses. This stage is what we recognize and call a moss plant, and is the generation where photosynthesis is taking place. Although each gametophyte can produce both female and male sex organs, they tend to only produce one kind to avoid self-fertilization. The male gametophytes have male sex organs called antheridia, or singular antheridium, which contain the male gametes, the sperm. The female gametophytes have female sex organs called archegonia, or singular archegonium, which contain the female gametes, the eggs. The sperm, called antherozoids, are released when rain droplets wet the antheridia, where they swim to the eggs in the archegonia. The sporophyte generation starts with the fusion of a haploid egg and a haploid sperm, called fertilization. This occurs within the archegonium on the female gametophyte. Once fertilization occurs, the diploid zygote is formed within the archegonium. The zygote continues to grow through mitosis first into an embryo, then into what is known as the sporophyte. The sporophyte grows up and out of the archegonium and as such are found on the female gametophytes. The mature sporophyte consists of three parts, the foot which anchors the sporophyte to the gametophyte, the seta which is a long stalk, and the capsule, also called the sporangium, which is pod-like and found at the end of the seta. Inside the capsule, haploid spores are created through the process of meiosis. These spores are then released and the cycle continues. And that concludes this video on the life cycle of a moss. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.